Good afternoon, everybody, and welcome to the Florida Flight 2014 season home opening game. Flight have already played four away games. Started out the season 1-3. They beat this team we're playing today, the Palm Beach Knights, in the season opener, and have dropped three in a row. Along with me today is Hank Taylor doing the color commentary. Hank, welcome aboard.
Thanks, John. Appreciate it being here. Excited for today's matchup with the Flight and the Knights. Hoping that they can bring out another win today against the Knights, which I believe is their only win of the season so far. So should see a good matchup here today. Hope for some high-powered offense from the Flight.
Those starting lineups are going to be announced here in just a moment. And then after that, we'll begin play. 12-minute quarters. Pretty much NBA rules. Coach Mark King gives a thumbs up. We're ready to do the starting lineups. Palm Beach with a distinctly different look this year, sporting new colors.
And a new name, I believe.
Yep, some beautiful new uniforms. Let's see if their play is as good as their new uniforms. Is Sylvester Banks. Number 30 is Omar Graham. Number 21, the big man in the middle, is Derek Nenwick. Number 17 is Taris Heath. And finally, number 15 is Rand Hoylett. Got a couple of very tall guys, but they look a little bit on the slender side. That looks like the Flight might have the edge in the muscle department.
It looks like the Flight have put on some muscle and are mostly made up of some bigger guys that look like they can be rough and push the pace, especially down near the basket. So we'll see if the Knights can keep up with them in those intense, action-packed moments where it's getting very physical.
There's Ernest Jones, number 10. It's Greg St. Remy, back with the Flight after playing for the Heartland Prowl and winning a championship last year. Number 33, Jonathan Adamson. This is the newcomer that everybody's so excited about, number 0, Chris Watson. I've been told that Chris had about 40 points the last outing. And number 23, Garvin Gordon, rounds out the Flight starting five. And of course, the head coach, Mark King. Flight in its fifth year of existence now, hard to believe. Flight made a new signing this week, signing Alex Richmond, a point guard who concluded his ABA season somewhere in Texas, I believe. And Flight picked him up for some backcourt help. We'll see if he gets in the game, and if so, what he does.
We'll be really excited to see what he can contribute after a successful run with another league, see if we can put him to work and get some points on the board for him this season as well.
We've got an immediate substitution, it looks like, number 9, Kumar Russell. Let's see who he starts the game in place of. Looks like Watson's going to take a seat starting the game. A little bit of a surprise there. I hope he's not injured because I want to see him play.
Absolutely. Maybe it's an attempt just to save him and maybe get it started to see if they need him to come in and push the pace a little later on.
I have to ask Coach King at halftime. Meantime, it's going to be Heath against Garvin Gordon in the jump circle.
And we're ready for tip-off here in downtown Orlando. A little bit of an early jump from the Knights. And we're off. Flight get the rebound deep
Jones for a quick three, in and out. Rebound.
Knights gain the possession, and they're pushing back down, and we seem to have a little bit of technical issues with the shot clock reset to 40 seconds, and I am fairly certain that that's way too much time.
Yeah, if they're playing by NBA rules, it's going to be a 24-second shot clock. If they're playing by college rules, then it's 45. So we'll see what they do. Right now, it looks like the shot clock is pretty much just going haywire. So we're going to have to have a break in the action until we get this figured out. Once again, if you're just tuning in, we're just underway. No score between the Florida Flight and the Palm Beach Knights here at the downtown rec center. Along with Hank Taylor, I am John Weiss, bringing you the action today. I guess it's only fitting when the air conditioning went out in game one of the NBA Finals that we should have a problem as well.
Temperature in here is also, I would say, not as favorable, but yeah. I'm sure we're figuring it out.
Still better than it probably was in San Antonio a couple nights ago. As a player, this is a little bit difficult because you just thought you were getting into the flow of the game, and all of a sudden there's a quick stoppage and you got to wait again.
Right, when you get yourself, you know, pumped up and, you know, your energy level is flowing and you start strong and get your rebound, and then you have to stop the game at the reset of a shot clock. That's got to be a little rough. These guys look like they're being good sports though, waiting it out. Yep. And just enjoying themselves a little bit.
Mm-hmm. Well, these two teams are no strangers to each other. They have played once before this year. Flight coming out victorious. I believe the game was a pretty close score though. And the Flight swept the season series last year, but this is an almost entirely new Palm Beach team. And I've been told they're much better than they were last year.
We'll see how they play together, I guess. If these guys are new, then we'll have to see if the chemistry on the floor is there. They can work together and work effectively against high-powered defense, get the buckets, and they do.
There's a basket by Hoylett off a good dish from Graham. 2-0 in favor of Palm Beach. This is Jones. Jones inside Adamson, out to St. Remy. He throws a head fake, spin move, pulls up for the jumper, banks it home. We're tied at 2. Graham with the rock. 11-10 to go, first quarter, game tied at 2. This is number 10, Banks. And what's the call there? Offensive foul?
Offensive foul on Knights number 10. I believe that's Banks. Banks called with a charge early on. It looks like these refs are not going to be messing around when calling the fouls.
St. Remy dribbles it. Gordon, top of the key to Jones. Inside Adamson.
And a foul on Knights number 21. I believe that was on a trip, accidental trip.
Fouls against the big man, Nenwick. I heard the refs say 14 on the shot clock. So 14 we are playing by NBA rules if they're going 14 there. Garvin Gordon inside. Righty hook.
Oh, in and out.
Off. We've got a call against the Flight. The foul's against Adamson. His first. Still tied at 2, 10:49 to go here in the first quarter. Banks to Graham. Jones picking him up full court.
Driving in, just getting across the half court. Banks with the ball, and he's down, trying to get rid of it. And
there's
the Flight with a steal,
Russell,
number 9.
Really goes out of bounds, stays in. There's St. Remy. Good pops pass to Ernest Jones. Gordon. Gordon gets called for... Well, I thought they were going to say 3 seconds. Instead, they get a foul. The foul goes against Graham of Palm Beach. Gordon wasn't expecting that pass when it landed.
Yeah, it would have been a really nice dump right to him, but if he wasn't quite ready for it, so... Jones. Well, it looks like they're going to try again, set something up.
Adamson fights for it. That ball goes out of bounds. Graham touched it last. It'll be flight ball.
Jones had a really risky move there, driving in like that through all that defense, hoping to try to come up with something, but looks like that didn't quite work out for him.
Just 4 on the shot clock right now.
Short time, and it's flight ball right underneath the basket.
Now they reset to 14. Not sure why, but they did.
So not quite as short of a time.
Gordon's jumper short. Rebound to Russell. Ball is raked out of his hands, and he goes sprawling. But Jones picks it up. St. Remy to Russell. Russell may have gotten away with the travel there. Gordon has it ripped away by Graham. Graham coast to coast. And he lays it in.
He comes up with that fast break point. Was able to keep himself out in front of the defense. And with that move and with that mindset, he was able to take it all the way to the hoop and not have any problems getting it there.
4-2 Knights lead, 9:35 to go, first quarter. St. Remy. He's got that one. It's just a 2. He's got both flight buckets. We're tied at 4. Banks guarded by St. Remy. This is Hoylett.
Head coach Mark King was calling for some more verbal action from the defense, calling them to action and making sure they're working their hardest.
He just called a foul on number 45. The flight don't have anybody by that number, so I'm not sure who that foul was against. Didn't appear to be much of a foul there. So referees are calling a very, very close game so far. Here comes Watson off the bench for the flight. Boy, look at his arms.
Flight definitely have a little bit more meat on their bones, and hopefully it'll give them the advantage in intense situations that are, you know, close and that are, you know, pretty rough.
Russell takes his seat. Watson comes in. First free throw by Heath was no good. He's got one more.
He gets able to come up with the second one, and it's flight ball headed back down the court.
St. Remy. Gordon. Gordon leans in, misses the shot. Good effort. Think he wanted a foul call, didn't get one. And the other way, Graham lays it in.
Knights able to come up with some really good passes down the court, and a good fake move down under the basket by Graham was able to come up with the basket for them.
Watson draws a double team. Now we got a foul. That foul against Graham. That may be 2 on him already.
And the flight call, a 30-second timeout.
Got some substitutions. Number 24 coming in for Palm Beach. That's Anthony Daniels. And number 2, Brandon Hernandez, also making his first appearance. Had lunch with Coach King during the week, and he was saying their transition defense is not up to par, and so far they've been bitten by that bug a couple times already by Palm Beach.
You need to have that defense in those, especially in those fast break scenarios when, you know, they're pushing the pace coming down the court. You got to be able to come up with something and be able to get yourself out in front in between them and the basket and really try to make some moves that way.
Jones gets a nice Watson screen, takes it in. Sort of a right-handed scoop shot, gets it to go. And Flight trail by just one now. 7-6, 8:25 to go first quarter.
Good move by Ernest Jones, able to adapt to the defense and was able to figure out the hole where he could lay it up and just lay it up there and leave it for it to come up with a basket.
On the other end, he makes a nice defensive play to knock the ball away from Hernandez. And we're having shot clock problems once again. Reset it to 17. And we are underway once again. There's a three-pointer by Banks. Didn't get it to go. Rebound Garvin Gordon. Shovels it to Jones, to Adamson. Adamson.
Right back out to the line.
Well short. And here we go. That was a good foul by Adamson, actually, even though it's his second. That was a good foul because there was about a 4-on-1 going the other way. And Alex Richmond makes his first appearance into the game. So he takes Adamson's spot in the lineup.
We'll see, even if though he's new to the team, if he can, you know, work with them and if he, you know, make plays and be able to come up with some points. Even though he's so new, we'll see if he can adapt to the team's style.
Well, I do know he got in a couple practices this week before the game, so. Banks is fouled. St. Remy came over, tried to help, and committed the foul. 7-6, Palm Beach leads. 7:46 to go, first quarter. Banks it to Charity Stripe, shooting a pair. First one too strong.
Banks missed his first of two. Trying again with the second.
Watson grabs the miss, and here comes St. Remy across the half-court line. Oh.
St. Remy passed it to heavy defense and ended up getting the ball swatted away, but it looks like Watson drew a foul.
I believe that foul was on Hernandez, number two, though. I'm not sure. There's a steal by Hernandez on the inbounds pass. Hoylett takes it all the way, and there's a foul. The foul goes against Richmond.
Hollier with a good move, just wasn't able to make it into the basket, went all the way around and out the other side. It looks like he'll get a shot at a couple free throws. Was able to pick up that first free throw. Looks like, based on the way the refs are calling this game, you're going to have to try to make every single one of your free throws, because that's going to be the... You're going to get a lot of free money that way if you can.
Jones swoops in, grabs the rebound of the miss, and St. Remy, his three-pointer, no good. Good rebound by Richmond in traffic. Not the biggest guy. And there's a basket by St. Remy. It counts. And the foul goes against Nedwick, number 21. That's his second.
And like you said, good defense down there by Richmond, who, even in a really heavy situation, not a lot of friendly faces down there that close, but he was still able to come up with it.
St. Remy, if he makes his free throw, can not to score at 9 with 7:16 to go here in the first quarter. And it's good.
Got hit, picked up his and one, and it's tied it up at 9.
St. Remy now has 7 of the Flight's first 9. Oh, terrible pass, picked off. Very sloppy by Pompey.
Tried to dump it behind.
That was a flop. That was a flop. Are you kidding me? Wow. Banks draws the the offensive foul. That was terrible.
I think the referees heard that foul more than they saw it, and they let out a big cry of anguish as he went down and called the foul that way.
Well, at any rate, taking the ball inside.
It's a blocking foul.
That foul goes against Jones.
And that's in Banks from the Knights to the line. He's been moderately successful today on the line, trying to pick up some extra points for the Knights, and he misses his first.
They've left a lot of points on the line already. They may come back to hunt them later in the game. Gets that one to go. And now they're saying the score is tied. I thought it was tied before. There's an attempt by Mincy, who just came into the game by the flight. Didn't get it to go. There's a nice assist from Daniels to number 33, Charles Lewis, who's in the game for the first time. And there's a steal stolen back by Jones to St. Remy. Here comes Watson. Oh, Watson's blocked. Dunk is blocked.
Watson was taking his time going up for that dunk. They gave the Knights enough time to come in and make a defensive move, block the ball.
Wow, we're going to have a timeout by the flight.
And that got the Knights on their feet off the bench, and they were really excited about that move.
Watson was about to perform a circus dunk.
Looks like the scoreboard finally caught up. Knights lead by 2. 9-11.
Well, it's just as we suspected. It's been a close game so far, and it's nothing between these two teams that would lead me to believe that there would be anything other than a close game. Usually is.
I think one area the Knights are excelling is in their defense and their defense's ability to get the ball, turn it over, and be able to get some of their points. That's how they've gotten a good portion of their points. And if they can keep the Knights guessing, be able to get some moves with their defense, that's what will be able to keep their lead.
Yep. Deflator is as good as anybody in this league when they set up their offense and play pretty much a half-court game. There's a steal, but stolen back by Watson. He's fouled. Coach off the bench wondering where that foul was. But they're calling it close both ways. Watson's going to go to the line for a pair. I think Watson's a little bit upset after the play right before the timeout in which his dunk attempt was blocked.
You can see in his face he's still a little perturbed about that one, but was able to come up with the free throw and help working towards getting some of those points back.
Successful free throw here will tie things at 11. And he gets the roll.
Picks up a Knights pair, ties it up. Knights push the pace into the paint.
Good defense by Watson there. And here they come the other way. Watson has it knocked away. And it bounced off his leg and went out of bounds, so it will be Palm Beach Knights basketball.
It was a good pass. He just wasn't able to hang on to it. And because of that, lost it off of his leg, gave it back the other way.
Fabian Samuta in the game number 4.
Just hasn't been going Watson's way so far today.
I don't care that went in. That was a terrible shot. A turnaround jumper from the baseline with the guy's hand in your face, but it went.
One-handed pass back to...
Rebound. Palm Beach, here they come the other way. Lewis, righty hook in the lane, no good. Second try, he gets the fortuitous bounce. And it's 15-11.
Lewis and his height was able to come up with that basket, even though he missed the first one, was able to get his own rebound, and good follow-up. Getting your rebound like that is what's going to help save you and help you get those extra points. And he was able to put it back up again, help get another basket for two.
Daniels, number 24, comes back in. Palm Beach really turning up the defensive pressure here.
Let's see if Watson can get something to go his way for once.
Takes it all the way. He's just too strong for anybody on Palm Beach to handle one-on-one. That foul against Quinn, number 3, who's just in the game.
See if Watson can make good on two more free throws. Get the points for that basket he wasn't able to get back.
Just under 5 minutes to go first quarter. 15-11 is your Palm Beach lead right now.
Getting ready to come in for the flight is number 44, Danny Rodriguez.
First one good.
Danny Rodriguez, another bigger guy up against a pretty scrawny and skinny Knights team. The Fly definitely have the advantage, I would say, as far as height goes and strength.
Well, he's got a nice touch on that, even though it didn't go in, it danced around the rim for a while. 15-12 is your score. Jones goes flying to the floor. There's a bad pass by Daniels, and it'll be flight ball.
I don't know who Daniels thought would be there, but I guess he wasn't. Knights tried to take advantage of that slow pass, rushed up to it.
Oh, bad pass by Jones.
Give it back to the Knights. Hernandez outside the arc, comes up with 3 points for the Knights.
6 points lead. There's another foul.
Lob pass into Watson, almost got it swatted out of his hands on that slow pass, that slow lob pass right over their heads.
Watson saw nothing but clear path. If he could have split those two guys. Probably a good foul by Hernandez to avoid an easy dunk for Watson.
Sends Watson back to the free throw line.
He's got a nice touch on those free throws.
Really does. They get there, and he's not ever worried about him. He knows what he's doing, and he knows how to shoot these. You could tell he's really put the work in practice to make sure that his free throws are on point. That one in and out, though.
This is Quinn with the basketball.
Double coverage right there on number 3.
Corey Williams, who's in the game, went for the steal.
Offensive foul, I believe.
Yep, foul win against
number 3, Quinn. Gives the flight the ball, moving back down the floor into number 22. That's Williams.
Rodriguez drills it. Dials long distance. And that cuts
very long distance, but just what they needed and bringing it back close. They're within two now.
Quinn throws a head fake. Too strong off the glass. Rebound, Williams.
Good defensive move by the Flight's number 22. Williams was able to be there and get the rebound.
Jones
and
for knew- three. No. Rebound, Corey Williams. Good head fake. Dishes it to Mincy. Back out to Williams. Williams. Mid-range jumper, no good.
Williams had a good defensive move, was able to come up with the rebound and knew the lane he had to pass through to get it outside so they can move the ball back down the floor. Really good defensive eye right there by Williams.
Foul goes against the Flight. It's going to be Palm Beach ball. Both teams now in the bonus. So Daniels is going to be shooting. both teams really racking up the fouls here in the early going.
The refs are calling it really close on both sides, like you said, so they should take that into account in their strategy, maybe save some of their better players and make sure that, you know, their whole squad is not out for the count by the time we get to the third quarter.
Once again, the Knights struggle at the line. Daniels misses both. Score remains 18-16. Flight can tie with the bucket here. Watson's jumper in and out. Williams, great hustle. Lays it in.
Really great rebound right there. Knew what he had to do, knew where the defense was, and knew how to just come right back underneath and out the other side.
Good move by Daniels. Doesn't get it to go. Here comes Watson with the rebound. He's fouled, and he'll go back to the line once again.
Watson really pushing the pace, even though he was double-teamed, was able to draw a foul in that situation, which is good, and probably a smart foul, too, because if he was able to get out in front, there would have been no stopping him at that point.
Like a runaway train.
Richmond getting ready to come back in for the flight.
First one good. Flight retake the lead that they had in the early going. Score is 19-18. He can put the flight up by two. And he does. Made a living at the free throw line so far. I want to see him dunk one. This is Lewis. Good crossover. He's fouled by Williams.
Williams didn't think he should have been called on that move. Just a little bit of physicality, but nothing to really consider to be called a foul. But he takes it nonetheless. He grins and bears it.
Williams didn't move his feet. He reached.
It sends the Knights Lewis to the line.
And again, another missed free throw.
They've got to be kicking themselves at this point from the free throw line.
There's a successful make. Flight still lead by one, 20-19. Cintron just entered the game, got away with the travel. Nice little dipsy-do by Williams, but it comes in and out. Strong drive to the basket by Heath, no good.
And probably another travel. Richmond passes out to Rodriguez, who does a good fake, moves in.
Oh.
And Watson
Chris
with a
Watson.
Slam dunk.
He looks at Brandon Hernandez and says, "Welcome to my poster."
That's right. Trying to get back at him for that free throw that they blocked last time. Just reminding him that just because you block me once doesn't mean you could do it every time.
That's right.
We'll be expecting some more power offense from Watson.
Richmond, good scoop.
Richmond with a really good assist into Watson, who just with much ease lays it right in on his way underneath.
Just like that, the Flight opened up a 5-point lead at 24-19, 1:48 to go here in the first quarter.
Flight have been on a really good run right here, have been able to use some of the physicality and the speed that comes with some of the bigger guys, stronger guys, been able to put up some good, easy points and a really stylish slam dunk as well, just to really solidify and get in their heads a little bit.
I don't think that Hernandez thought he could jump that far from where he took off and make it all the way to the rack, but he did. With ease. That seems to have energized the Flight. I'm not even playing it, and it energized me, so I can.
The guys came off the bench back onto the court with smiles on their faces, and they seem to be feeling pretty good, so.
So it's Richmond and Cintron in the backcourt. Kamar Russell, Corey Williams, and Gordon on the floor for the Flight.
It's Hernandez keeping the pace, trying to make moves inside. Dump pass to nobody. Number 21
Cintron's
able to come up with it.
The advantage here. Lays it up. Doesn't get it to go. Russell tried to follow slam. Didn't get it to go. And now the Knights have numbers the other way. There's a lob to Lewis.
There's an alley-oop from the Knights, number 33, Adamson.
It's Lewis.
These teams are playing for style points. Looks like they're going to be trying to one-up each other all day. So we'll see how that goes for them.
Garvin Gordon is fouled. He'll shoot a pair. Gordon is an extremely streaky free throw shooter. He'll make 6-7 in a row, and then he'll have some trouble. First one goes. That's a good sign.
For the Knights, number 24, Daniels, comes back in. Goes down low here, maybe looking to get a rebound if this next free throw is a miss.
Flight doing an outstanding job at the line, and that's part of the reason why they have a lead right now. Hernandez inside to Hoylett. He scores and draws the foul.
Number 15, Hollier, comes up with a basket even though he's fouled and will be going for an and one.
The foul goes against Kamar Russell for the Flight. 26-23 is your score. Minute 5 to go, first quarter. There's a successful free throw.
Seems to put that one in with ease. Gets it within two. Flight moving the ball back down. Gives it to Williams.
Okay, he's open. There he is. Richmond. Good head fake. Dumps it off to Gordon.
Gordon almost wasn't ready.
Short. Rebound Daniels. Under a minute to go, first quarter. Good head fake by Lewis. Doesn't get it to go. The
nice follow-up. Follow-up from Knights, number 30, Graham, was able to eye that ball had a little bit of trouble and was able to give it a little bit of help. Gordon got the ball swatted out of his hands.
Wow.
Corey Knights, Williams, number 24, Daniels.
Williams takes it all the way. He's fouled. Once again, they're calling it close. That foul goes against Hoylett.
And it looks like that sends Williams to the line.
Starting to wonder if there's going to be any players left after about midway through the third quarter where they're calling all these fouls. First one up and good for Sewell.
It's going to make the difference for the Flay, all their success so far on the line. Sending back in number 7, St. Remy.
And he ties the score at 28. 23 seconds left to go. Let's see if they try to hold for one shot.
Knights seem to be taking their time trying to set up. Hernandez seems to be in a little bit of trouble.
5 seconds, they better move soon.
Hernandez takes a long shot three, doesn't quite come up with it.
Oh, nice. Daniels up and under, using the rim as a shield. Connects on a reverse layup to put the Palm Beach Knights up by two, 30-28 at the end of one.
Good move by Daniels. It puts them up at the end of the first quarter here, and a little bit of frustration down here on the Flight bench. Thought that they could have held that one off, but weren't quite able to do it, and you could tell they're a little bit frustrated with that. Here at the start of the second quarter, It's going to be Knights ball. Knights number 33 is going to be bringing it in. Gives it off to 30, who pushes it in. Tries to lean in and jump, but didn't get very far off the ground there. That's Graham. Graham didn't have a lot of success down there by the taller and stronger Flight defense.
Oh, good help.
Hernandez went up for the shot, but it was blocked, was able to get the rebound, come back, and put it in for two.
Delay of game warning.
It looks like we got Flight moving down the court really fast. Into number 10, out to number 7. Number 7 is St. Remy. Back over there to the corner.
Fell's going to go against Daniels of Palm Beach. It's a defensive 3-second violation. That's a technical foul. And St. Remy.
Number 2, Hernandez, seems to be a little miffed at that call, but it sends St. Remy to the line. And a miss, a brick on his first. And it's Flight ball. St. Remy going to be inbounding the ball. Out to Richmond at the top.
Good screen by Adamson.
Really good screen. Dumps it to Jones. Wasn't quite able to get it in with a trying to have a quick move. Knights number 33 dumps it in to number 15
good
and a block
by Gordon.
Gordon showing he can play defensively as well. Uses height to put a palm on that one and stop that one in, but it looks like number 24,
Daniels
is going to come up with a basket.
Garvin Gordon was already starting to make his move, but he forgot to catch the ball.
Just touched his hands and then just went, kept on going.
Knights up.
Unfortunate six. Mistake, but it gives the ball back to the Knights. Hernandez is at the top. He's making some moves, gets around the defense, lays it in, but was way off base. Number 30 comes Graham. Up with it. That's Graham, comes up with it.
Full court pressure from the Knights.
Flight has some slow passes. Richmond outside the arc gets tripped, but still comes up with the three-point move. The new point guard showing that he can still put some money in the basket.
They called fouls on everything else. And Richmond got hammered on that one.
Back down to Richmond.
Oh, good try.
Tries to do the reverse dump, but gives it right back to the Knights. Hernandez moving in.
Good defense by St. Remy underneath. Daniels for three. He drove.
Daniels with a really good three-point move. Kept moving it in, and then the ball got sent back out. Some sloppy passes by the Flight.
I think the Flight could use a timeout right now. And they could use Watson back in the game as well.
That's very true. Foul call on Flight number 10, I believe. And it sends Hollier to the line for a pair. The Knights have gone on a pretty significant run here, putting them up 8 points here early in the second quarter. Hollier comes up with his first one. We got some substitutions coming in here for the Knights.
Watson and Williams come back in. Richmond and Garvin Gordon come out. Back into the game for Palm Beach is number 10, Banks.
Flight kept a man, an extra man in the backcourt, ended up working out really well. I guess they figured he was going to miss that free throw, which he did. St. Remy at the top and into Watson. Watson danced around and sends it back out, brings it back in. Adamson is able to
spin move. He scores.
Adamson with a really nice spin move, able to get right around the defense and put it right where it needed to be.
Right at the right time.
Good timing.
The entire possession was very unselfish by the Flight. Everybody made the extra pass. Spin move, Heath banking it in. 42-33, Flight now down by 9. And there's another steal.
Again, another sloppy pass.
Good block by C. Will. Now there's a foul against Palm Beach.
Foul called somewhere on Knights number 33. That's Charles Lewis. Sloppy pass from the Flight. Ended up not mattering because it's going back the Flight's way.
Adamson got clobbered in the eye. He's bleeding.
Adamson in the floor had a little scuff, and floor got him right above the eye.
Oh, he's going to have a nice shiner. And
looks like he's going to take a little bit of some injury time, but looks like he'll recover just fine.
He'll have a good story to tell on Monday at the law firm he works at. He's in his shirt and tie with a big shiner in his eye.
If he puts some Vaseline on it, it should be okay. Looks like St. Remy's going to inbound the ball for the Flight. With Jones also in the backcourt as well.
Adamson heading into the locker room.
And Watson way down by the basket. Jones is bringing it in. Jones is at the top looking for a man. Can't find one. Takes it in all the way to the outside. Still struggling. Finds Williams, though, also in trouble.
Ooh, almost got it to go.
They're in some trouble down there. But another Knights foul.
That one goes against Heath.
Knights are just racking them up. Flight have to be really careful on offense with their passes. They're taking their time with their passes, keeping them really slow. But the Knights are playing very aggressively here and are always looking to try to dink a pass on out and turn that around into a fast break point, because that's where they excel in their speed. Knights got to be really intentional, or the Flight, excuse me, have to be very intentional about their passes and make sure that it's not just regular shipping, but it's got to be overnighted. Got to get there with purpose.
St. Remy on Lewis like a cheap suit, forces a turnover, and it's Flight ball.
Some high pressure by the Flight are able to turn it over, give it back to them. So really good turnover right there. Jones to Williams inside, lays it up, gets a nice pair.
Good assist by EJ on that one. Well, Adamson comes out of the locker room with some athletic tape around his head. It looks like a headband. That's going to hurt when he takes that off. Bad pass, but Mincy does haul it down.
Hail Mary.
Somehow.
Hail Mary pass.
Mincy misses a layup.
Into Jones.
But seals it back.
And another lob pass.
That one's taken away and restolen. Now it's restolen.
Both teams got to be careful with their handling. It's turned into some bad situation. St. Remy out to Watson. And now it's just Hernandez and St. Remy down at the basket. And Hernandez misses it.
Hernandez is on the end line when he touched the ball, so it's Flight ball. That was one of the uglier sequences you'll see.
Goes back to old school handling. You can't forget that, and you can't not practice that. You always got to be able to handle the ball, make sure you have good ball control, and be able to come up with it in key situations and be able to control the ball and know what you're doing with it. Jones on the outside looking for a man, finds Williams, who moves around.
Ooh, did a good job of maintaining possession there. Good head fake. St. Remy scooper, no good. Tries to follow, doesn't get it to go. Here comes Lewis the other way.
Jones tried his hand at a little bit of defense there. Williams comes
behind,
over the top.
That should be Flight ball. If that's a clean block, it went off of Heath. Williams blocked it from behind, and then it bounced off Heath and went out of bounds. Here comes Adamson back in the game. I want you to look closely at this makeshift headband that he made to try to stop the bleeding.
Very nice. It's the high basketball fashion with just some athletic tape. Yeah. You can still see the blood that shows through a little bit where he got conked earlier.
It's going to hurt when he takes it off and pulls his hair, too. But that's the competitor to him. He just wants to get back in the game as quickly as possible. And he'll worry about the pain later. Five on the shot clock. They got to get it up there quick. And there's a basket by Heath. Breakdown in the last 5 seconds. They played great defense for 20 seconds and then blew it. 44-37 is your score.
St. Remy up top gets fouled.
It's a foul on Samuda.
Playing a little too aggressive on defense sometimes. It can end up being called a foul, especially with these refs.
Quinn comes back in. And it looks like Heath takes a seat.
St. Remy inbounding, got it inside to Jones. Williams is on the opposite side. Watson trying to come in and give him some help. Watson almost loses it. Yep. Gets fouled trying to go underneath.
I was just about to say, if I'm the flight, I give the ball to Watson as often as possible. He's just a beast down there.
Really good at controlling the ball. You saw he almost lost it, but was able to regain control right underneath the basket and still was able to put it right back up when he needed to, but just came up a little short. But Watson back on the free throw line, and it looks like some Knights are getting ready to transition out. Get some new faces on the floor.
44-37 is your score. We're down to 6:23 before halftime. Palm Beach has led much of the way, as they do right now. Flight with Jones, St. Remy, Adamson, Corey Williams, and Chris Watson, who's at the line. That's the five for the Flight on the floor. Daniels comes back in, Hoylett comes out. So that leaves Banks, Samuda, Quinn, Lewis, and Daniels on the floor for Palm Beach.
Watson's been good for a lot of things so far today. This is one of them right here, getting the money when it counts on the free throw line. Not right then, though.
There's a steal. Lazy pass. Terribly lazy pass by Lewis. Good heads-up play by Corey Williams. He draws the foul against Banks. And he'll go to the line. But that foul is squarely the fault of Lewis for his lazy pass.
Absolutely. Both teams have been lazy with their passes so far. And just got to make sure, like we said earlier, have some purpose behind your pass. Make sure that you know where it's going and you make sure that it gets there.
First free throw up and good.
Even in those easy inbound situations.
Too strong for Sewell on the second one. Flight have drawn to within five now.
Adamson was able to get a hand on it, pry it loose, and sent them back down the floor with little control, and it ended up with them getting it out of bounds and back into the Flight's hands. St. Remy bringing it back down the floor, back into Watson. Watson moving in.
Yep, there's
and
the foul.
picks up the and one. Like you said, give it to Watson as much as you can.
That foul goes against Quinn. Two guys came over and tried to stop him, still couldn't do it. 44-41 is your score. A successful free throw here can cut the Knight lead to just a bucket. And there it is.
We're within two here with about 6 minutes left here in the second quarter. Flight gone on a pretty good run here.
Good defense by Jones.
Adamson comes up with a nice steal, bringing it down the floor by numbers. Himself into Jones, into St. Remy. Gets an easy basket. Really good play and really good assist. Good eye by Jones, able to get it in, and that ties it up.
Yep, that's an unselfish play. Ernest Jones could have taken him himself and had a challenge layup. Instead, he passed it ahead to St. Remy for the uncontested deuce. And we have a timeout. 44-44 with 5:44 to go here before halftime.
Lots of fours.
That's a good strategic timeout by the Palm Beach coaching staff. The Flare are really gaining some momentum there.
Coming out of the huddle saying defense, and you know that they need to do that with how aggressive the Knights have been. Even though they're not as strong, have been playing very aggressive, and they need to make sure that they can keep their heads on straight when with their aggressiveness, and maybe use their own aggressiveness to the Flight's advantage to be able to pick apart their defense and maybe be able to get the ball back in a few situations.
Some full court pressure by the Flight.
With St. Remy all the way down.
Just sort of token pressure as they drop back into regular man-to-man defense now.
Banks brought it in.
Samuda has it tipped away. It's going to be Knights basketball. 7 on the shot clock.
Banks will be delivering the inbound, and we got a substitution. Hernandez coming back in for the Knights and taking out number 4. Banks still at the inbound. Hernandez made the move. Made it outside.
They've got to shoot.
Having a little bit of trouble with some double coverage. Dumped it back out to Banks, and that's a shot clock violation.
Banks is screaming, why didn't somebody tell me? The coaching staff yelled 7 seconds before they inbounded the ball. Banks just wasn't paying attention, apparently. Flight can actually take the lead here.
Defense really paid off at that point. Was able to hold them off long enough to get the shot clock violation to get the ball back. Adamson with it at the top, moving around, looking for somebody. Gives it to Watson. No surprise there.
Good
but
steal by Banks. Good defense by Adamson.
And a really good bounce pass out, back out to Williams. Stuck it right in between the defense. Gives it to Jones.
Ooh.
Jones got fouled and almost came up with it. Bounced out, looked like it was going back in and came back out the other side.
There's another foul against Banks. That's 3 on Banks.
Jones here at the line could take the lead with this bucket.
Nope. Jones usually a very good free throw shooter. I fully expect him to make the second one. Wholesale substitutions for the Flight as St. Remy and Williams exit into the game. Is Rodriguez and Russell back. And a fight with the 1-point lead now, 45-44.
Hernandez bringing it in, out to Banks. Banks trying to make a move inside. Jump blocked by Watson. Watson showing his value on defense.
That was too easy. Banks tried to throw a fake, and Watson wasn't buying what he was selling and just stayed on his feet until...
Watson wasn't even fazed. He didn't even have to work too hard for that block.
Nope. There's a bad pass by Banks. 4.5 to go before halftime. Flight with a 1-point lead in the ball.
Banks tried to play wall ball, but the wall's not playing today.
Russell rises up and fires. No good. I think Watson may have gotten away with a foul there.
Russell able to get a palm on it, but sends it right back into the Knights' hands.
Yep, over the back. Can't do that. Who was that foul on? I believe that foul went against Lewis, and he's taking a seat. So
I believe so, too. I believe so as well. This sends Adamson to the line.
So one number 33 fouled the other number 33.
Hopefully his earlier head trauma will not disrupt his free throw shooting abilities.
Too strong.
Kissed it right off the back. A little too much heat on it. Flight shuffling around, send Russell and Rodriguez into the backcourt.
Second one right on the money. Flight now up two. Scores 46-44. 4:12 to go before halftime. This is Samuda. Back to Banks. Banks with a long three.
Banks with a long three from downtown. Wasn't able to come up with it. Rodriguez fumbled around with it a little bit. Knight sent it off of Jones' leg out of bounds. Jones now swapping out for Richmond.
Good move. He did everything but finish. That was Banks. Here comes Watson the other way.
Watson and Richmond.
Richmond for three. Bang.
What a three. Watson and Richmond are a really good duo. They're always looking for each other, and now with Richmond having some time to the bench to recover, while some of these Knights players might be a little more tired, Richmond has rested up and is able to put in those deep threes. A good eye from Watson, another unselfish move, able to give it out to Richmond when Watson could have very easily taken it in himself.
Richmond taking it all the way after a rebound to miss, and he scores. And he goes tumbling, and now we have a timeout by Palm Beach, and all of a sudden, the Flight have a 51-44 lead with 3:15 to go before the half. Just like that.
Just like that. Richmond seems to be a really key player here for the Flight. They bring him in late into the quarter when the Knights seem to be a little bit more tired, and Richmond really pushes the pace and is able to come up with baskets and take advantage of a tired team.
About 5 minutes ago, it was a 9-point Palm Beach lead, so I wonder what the run is since then. It's got to be pretty
substantial.
Pretty substantial.
We have some new Knights coming in.
They're Twin Towers, Heath and Nentwick are coming back into the game just to try to get some height to challenge Watson and protect the rim a little bit. As long as the Flight take care of the basketball, they can pretty much get whatever they want. They just have a propensity to turn the ball over from time to time.
And it goes back to those passes. You got to make sure that your passes are, you know, doing their job and making sure that they're getting where they're supposed to go. And you don't take care of the ball that way, and this aggressive Knights defense will be able to pick off your passes.
Sometimes doing the simple things is better than trying to do the spectacular things. Banks.
Richmond with really good defense.
Cintron and Richmond switch. That's Quinn. His jumper is no good.
Russell comes up with it, dumps it out.
This is Cintron. And Mincy. Russell. Gordon head fakes. Now a second head fake. Cintron with one of his own. Six on a shot clock. Russell.
Russell with a nice drive in. Leaned into it a little bit and laid it right up there. Got as close as he could to it and still was able to come up with it.
Flight with a 9-point lead, their largest of the contest. And here's a steal. Here comes Kamar Russell. Jailbreak. He was just about ready to throw one down with some authority.
Graham, though, played a really good catch-up game right then. Was able to close the distance and get a hand on it on the way up.
Russell
but resulted in a foul.
Russell can get up, too. He was measuring his steps.
And that's his third foul. Seems to me like there have been a lot more. Well, you'll see these fouls start to add up late into the third and probably in the fourth quarter as well. These guys are going to have to sit for a little while longer, and guaranteed a few of them will have to come out.
That first free throw wasn't Kamar's best effort. Let's see if the second one will be better. He can put the Flight up by 10 here with 2:16 to go before halftime. Nope. Didn't get it.
No double-digit lead yet. Knights ball headed back down.
Graham cut off by Russell.
Graham struggling with the defense a little bit.
Richmond gets called for a defensive 3-second violation. And that'll put Hoylett.
Technical violation.
Puts Hoylett at the free throw line.
Able to come up with an easy one.
He seems to be about the only Knights player that's been successful at the line today.
Cuts it to an 8-point deficit for the Knights.
Knights ball, 14 on the shot clock.
Lob pass into number 2, Hernandez. Gordon and the defense batted it around a little bit, wasn't able to come up with it.
That foul goes against Cintron.
Sends Daniels to the line. Popped around a little bit, but Daniels is able to come up with it. Daniels going up again. Comes up with 2. Jones pushing the pace, taking it all the way.
Coast to coast, Mincy scores. That's Ed Mincy.
What a good play, good move. It's good to be resourceful and know what your other guys are doing, but sometimes if you know you could just do it yourself, it takes a special kind of player to be able to say that and to do that. Gives it out to Jones again.
Here's a 3. Oh.
Richmond's 3 was so close. We're used to seeing those go in from him.
That one would have given the Flight an 11-point cushion. But not to be. Just under a minute and a half to go before halftime now. 55-47 is the Flight lead. There's a steal by Mincy. Here's Gordon. What's he going to do?
Gordon draws the foul.
That foul goes against Quinn. Quinn wanted the charge.
I believe that's his 5th foul.
Even their coach is saying, no, you fouled him. You were still moving. And not only was he moving, but once you get to a certain area underneath the basket, they're going to call a block on you every time. You have to be outside, a couple of feet outside the area around the basket to even consider getting a charge call. So a good call by the officials.
I'm fairly certain that was his 5th foul as well, so that's another Knight player that's going to be out.
First one, no good. Samuta in. Graham comes out. Quinn comes out. That's a lot of fouls to rack up in 1 half.
And they'll feel it in the 2nd half. They can't have some of their key players.
9-point lead again for the Flight as Gordon makes the free throw. Mincy active hands again on defense. It's about his 3rd steal in a very short period of time. Bad pass by Gordon. 2-on-0.
Another sloppy pass.
Daniels missed a dunk.
Missed the lane with no one around. You know he'll be kicking himself for that in the locker room at half.
Good block from behind.
Richmond hustles, catches up.
Now let's see if he gets it this time.
17 with an easy dunk. That's Heath. Able to get it in. And we had a couple player pile up down here. And kept some of the Flight tied up. Gives it back to Jones.
And there's a reach around. It's another foul against Hernandez. And Mincy's going to go to the line.
Hernandez, one of the more aggressive of the Knights.
Mincy's had a nice 2nd quarter. very active hands on defense. He made a nice driving layup earlier.
Mincy been really key this quarter.
Oh, missed both free throws. But Gordon.
Gordon able to come up with it.
Somehow got between the basket and the Knights player and stole the rebound.
Back to that 9-point lead from earlier with 20 seconds left. Flight defense working really hard to try to get it back.
Oh, no. Oh, no. Richmond can't believe the call, and neither can I. He anticipated that play, took a step up in the lane, and raised his hands and just stood there, and then got called for the foul. Come on.
Definitely established his presence there first. I completely agree. Don't know where that came from.
Justice is served as Daniels.
He had a really good eye, able to saw the move before it happened and get there. And then gets punished for it, gets called for the foul.
Richmond shaking his head says to Coach King, did you see that? Yeah, we saw it, don't worry. Rattles home the second one. 8-point lead. Push it, Cintrone. 8 seconds, 7, 6.
Flight gonna try to come up with a last minute basket.
Mincy takes it in, his runner no good.
And Knights send it all the way back down. Of the Hail Mary shot, no good. Flight with a really solid 8-point lead at the end here of the first half. Going into the second half, the Knights are going to be feeling all the fouls that they've gotten so far, and we're going to see if they tone it down a little bit, their aggressiveness, just so they can keep some of their key players off of the bench and out and in the game.
Halftime score is 58-50 in favor of the Flight. And we've got about a 13-minute break in between now and the start of the third quarter. Hopefully we will get an interview with Flight Coach King after they come back out, or possibly even a player. It kind of depends upon who's available. And we'll come back and be with you at that time. Until then, we're going to sign off. Ready to start the third quarter. Flight once again with a 58-50 lead. It's going to be Palm Beach ball to start the third quarter. Looks like the same starting fives for both teams. No, actually, that's not true because Hernandez didn't start the game and he's in.
That's very true.
He's on the bench is Nentwick, who started the game for Palm Beach, the big guy.
If their starters haven't fouled out yet, they're pretty close, so I imagine they're trying to save some of that for later on situations where there's a little bit more pressure. Seem to be having some trouble with the head table.
having an argument about the score, perhaps? Coach King makes his way over to the scorer's table also to see what's going on.
Start of every half, I guess something's gotta slow him down a little bit.
Yep. St. Remy and Graham having a very animated conversation in the backcourt. I always wonder what kind of stuff is going on up there. Well, it looks like the score is going to remain 58-50. I'm not exactly sure what the commotion is here. But everybody seems to be satisfied with whatever happened, so here we go. We are finally underway.
And we're off to the races.
Good pressure.
Almost another sloppy pass. Goes up for the alley-oop. Comes up a little short. Heath wasn't able to quite come up with it. Went right through his hands. Gordon and Jones.
Adamson.
Inside to Adamson.
Oh.
Underneath.
No good.
Underneath and no good.
That's Adamson's patented move. Good block by Kamar Russell. Russell was at or near the block shot leaders in the FBA last year, and he shows you why there. Tremendous leaping ability. Now there's a steal by Russell, and he has a stolen right back.
Look down to the flight bench. You see Watson and Richmond both taking it easy, taking a break, catching their breath, making sure that they'll be 100% when I'm sure they'll come in later on in the quarter.
But Lewis drove the baseline and is wondering if he can find out the number of that truck that just hit him. I can tell it's number 23, Garvin Gordon. Gordon draws the foul, though. I don't know how that was a shooting foul. He wasn't, Coach King also saying he wasn't shooting. But they give him it.
Wasn't okay with that call, but that's a pair for the Knights. A rarity for them.
58-52 is your score. Jones takes it inside, and he scores.
Really good move, my Jones.
St. Remy swipes at the ball. Now here's a three-point attempt by Hernandez. Well short. Rebound, Russell.
It felt quite short indeed. Russell and Jones exchange for a little bit. Get it to St. Remy. St. Remy making a move inside. Plants in the jump. It bounces rebound off Gordon. The back.
Gordon, lefty layup, no good. Tip up, no good. Rebound, Graham the other way for Palm Beach.
Graham danced around a little bit, took it in, and got a pair out of that.
I need some water.
Out of bounds, and it's going back the Knights' way. Hernandez is going to be, changing it up. Graham with inbound. Timeout.
There's a double team. Banks comes out of it. Hernandez for three. Again, short.
Adamson with a good rebound. Pass out to Russell. Down to the corner to St. Remy with the jump. Banks off, and it's back to Hernandez.
Good head fake by Graham. Hernandez for three again. Finally gets it to go. And just like that.
Yeah, no coverage until the last second.
1 point ball game now.
Quick passes, Jones. St. Remy to Jones to Adamson, and it's out of bounds going back the Knights way. Flight seemed to be taking a little bit better care of the ball in those pass transitions. And we get a timeout.
Finally, Coach King gets his timeout. He was signaling for a 20-second timeout two trips ago. Down to 9-10 here in the third quarter. And it's a one-point Flight lead at 60-59. Flight were up 58-50 at halftime. So it's a 9-2 quick run out of the gate here in the first 2 minutes and 50 seconds for the Palm Beach Knights. I think it's time for Mr. Watson to re-enter the game, if you ask me. Palm Beach can take the lead with the bucket here.
Banks brought it in. Out to Graham. Graham to Hernandez, and they're dancing around at the top.
Daniels is short on a jump shot. Rebound Adamson. St. Remy, good crossover. Here's Kamar Russell. Takes it in. Good layup.
Good move by Russell. Crossed under and was able to put it back up for a nice pair. Easy pair.
Big bucket there for the Flight. They needed that. Garvin Gordon moves his feet and cuts off the much shorter Graham.
Graham really brought the pressure right there on defense. Looks like a faulty step by Banks. Got the ball out of bounds, and it's Flight ball. St. Remy to take it in.
His foot was on the line when he touched the ball.
Jones to Russell. Back to St. Remy inside. Batted it around a little bit, but it's back to the Knights.
Come on, Flight, get back. They let Daniels go coast to coast. Nobody stepped up and stopped the ball.
Pass to Gordon, struggled with it, got it to Adamson, and off the knee and out of bounds. And it looks like Watson's going to be making a trip in, replacing Gordon. It's a one-point game with the Flight leading.
Banks decides not to take the three. Now his pass is poked away. Jones has control of it. Here's Russell. Flight have numbers. What are they going to do? Oh, they called a foul on Adamson. He can't catch a break.
Adamson called on the offensive foul. And a little bit of tension on the floor.
You can just see Adamson's blood pressure rising by the second. He's been on the short end of a couple of questionable calls. If you notice where Russell's wiping the perspiration off the floor, when you're that far under the basket, there's no way there can be a charging foul.
Knights ball, Banks taking it into Hernandez, calling for a play and a Hail Mary pass all the way down.
This is Samuda, his jumper. Short. Rebound by that's Daniels. He drives around St. Remy, loses control. Lewis picks it up.
Lewis back out to Hernandez, who dumps it back.
Banks for three, way off. Rebound.
Another Adamson rebound. St. Remy put it over the top into Jones, drives in, comes up a little bit short. Got batted around and got away from Russell, who was reaching for it.
That's flight ball. That's flight ball. Good call. The referee under the basket couldn't see, but the second guy came up and said that ball went off the Palm Beach player, and he is correct. 62-61 is the score. It's been that way for a little while now. 6:55 to go here in the third quarter. Flight clinging to that one-point lead.
And here comes Richmond getting ready to come in for the flight. Like we saw in the second quarter, when you get him and Watson together, there's it's going to lead to some baskets.
And a foul. St. Remy.
Speaking of Watson, help St. Remy get that ball to the basket. St. Remy on the line going for his and one. Another big basket for the flight, and this free throw could have helped them a lot more, widened the deficit just a little bit more, but wasn't able to come up with it.
64-61 your score. This is Daniels against Watson. Banks, EJ guarding him. Pass down low to Lewis, who was wide open. He had gotten behind Corey Williams, but Lewis lost the handle and it'll be flight ball. Richmond, that's a moving screen against C. Will. Yep. Can't do that, Corey. Sorry. You can do that for about a half a step before
they catch you on that.
This is Daniels against Watson. Watson does a good job of staying on his feet, not going for the fake. Hernandez, Daniels. Daniels kicks it back out. One on the shot clock. And a 24-second shot clock violation.
Hernandez threw it up in hopes of getting it close. He put it over the top of the backboard, trying to avoid the shot clock violation, maybe get it off the rim. But it's going to be flight ball.
Tremendous defense that time down by the flight.
Jones getting it in to Richmond. Working the angles up top, passes it back to Jones, who's working. Looking for Williams, but can't quite find him. Some really aggressive defense right there from Knights number four, Samuda.
He didn't have to do that either, because Jones couldn't go anywhere. All he had to do was stand up with his hands up. He went for the steal and didn't get it. Jones does a tremendous job of calling timeout. He fell down when he got the ball before he could get tied up or before they called him for traveling.
That's true. It was a misstep by Jones.
Smart,
but really good at knowing where the refs were and being able to call that timeout, making sure that they could retain possession of the ball.
Yep. Flight still leading by three, 64-61. 5:41 to go.
Been
here.
A little bit of a slower quarter here for the flight as far as offense goes. They were at 58 at the half and have only gotten 6 points.
It's time to get the ball to Watson. And if I'm Coach King, that's what I'm telling my squad. You've got a guy who's bigger and stronger than everybody else out there on the floor. And a tremendous athlete to boot. Need to get him the ball. St. Remy.
Waves a nice pass inside to St. Remy. Gets it to Watson, like we were saying. Watson working the angles inside. Missed one, but got the second.
Just too strong for everybody else out there. Nice leaner by Lewis, doesn't get it to go. Richmond goes tumbling as he attempts to get the rebound, and it goes off of him out of bounds to Palm Beach.
He had his fingers on it. I think he got tripped up trying to get over a Knight player. Ended up losing control and giving them back the ball in their own territory.
5-point flight lead at 66-61, 5:22 to go third quarter. Samuda against Richmond. He spins.
Really nice spin. Even though he's probably the smallest player on the floor, really good at being fast and being able to pick apart some of the bigger guys.
Ooh, wow.
There's a foul called against Lewis that negated a 2-on-0 Palm Beach fast break there. I think the Flight may have cut a break on that one, and we'll take it.
Absolutely. St. Remy bringing it in.
There's a foul against Samuda, getting a little too physical with Jones.
That's been the name of his game. All game so far, it's been physical. And sometimes a little too physical. This sends Jones to the line. Going to pick up some easy points for the Flight, hopefully. First one is up and down. Good. Jones gearing up for his second free throw. It's up and also good. Jones, a very good free throw shooter, gives him a little bit more of a substantial lead.
Banks takes it in and delivers the mail. We've got a foul.
Foul on Jones.
Chance to complete a three-point play here for Sylvester Banks. Cut the Flight lead to two.
We have some substitutions coming in for the Flight.
Wow.
Mincy and
Cintrone. Flight just got noticeably shorter in that substitution. They've got three fairly short guys now in the game.
Watson comes up with a rebound without even having to jump forward or really try. That too hard.
Cintrone hits a baseline jumper. It's his first two of the game. 76-65.
Really good move. He was in the right place at the right time. When the ball came around the loop, he was there and was able to come up with a good point. It's a 5-point lead.
Good job of moving his feet by Watson.
Whatever Watson does, it almost looks effortless.
There's another foul against Samuda. Richmond's going to go to the line for his efforts. Richmond seems to have a good idea of when to force the action, when to just sit back and play casual. And that's the mark of a smart guy.
He is a very smart guy. Good at knowing where his teammates are, making plays, and like you said, being able to read the action and know when he has to make the play or if the other team's going to make it for him and send him to the line. He's coming in for the Knights, another tall guy.
Oh, missed them both. That one did everything but go down, too. That was a tough shot by Banks, but he gets it to go. And it's 70-67.
Lazy pass, lazy inbound right there resulted in the Knights getting the ball back right back at home. Cintron tried to come back up with it and save it. Ended up stepping out of bounds as a result. A little over 4 minutes left to go here in the third quarter, and it's a three-point lead for the Flight. Hernandez's miss.
There's a rebound by Graham. Doesn't get it to go. Who's that foul on? That foul goes against Watson, but he's not in any danger of
coming out.
Trouble. I would like to see Coach King take Cintron off of Hernandez. Such a difference in height that Hernandez just is shooting right over the top of him.
Graham is up. Bounces out. Still at that three-point lead. Graham going up for it again. Here it is. It's up. Off the side again. Watson comes up with a good rebound with no contest. Cintron all the way out to Richmond, who's going to go up for three. Bounces around a little bit, but does it go in?
Good
Watson.
Effort by Mincy. Oh.
Watson and Mincy fighting over the rebound, sends it out of bounds.
70-67 remains the score, 3:45 to go here in the third quarter. Wow, a long three by Banks, no good. Kind of an ill-advised shot. You can pretty much get that shot anytime you want it.
Some quick
passes. Richmond outside the arc again, going for three, and it's a miss again.
Flight need to get back.
Graham picks it up. It goes for the fast break.
Followed by Heath. He blew it. Can the Flight capitalize? We'll find out. Here comes C. Will. And he's fouled.
Setting up, got nowhere close, but got fouled pretty hard. He's going to go for a pair on the line. And they send Cintron and Richmond into the backcourt.
Williams knew that he had the Palm Beach players on their heels, so he just took it strong to the hole, leaned in and drew the contact.
There's a good free throw right there. Looks like a full timeout called by the Knights.
And Williams will have one more when we return to action. Right now it's 71-67.
Full timeout Flight. Gives everybody a nice sit break. Williams has one more free throw attempt. Could make it a 5-point lead once more. Just over 3 minutes to go.
Trying to listen to what Coach King is telling his team, but I can't quite make it out. I'm guessing it's get back on defense and take care of the basketball. And maybe even a little give the ball to number zero mixed in.
Looks like Rodriguez for the Flight might be making a move in here soon. Here comes Williams with his last free throw attempt. It's up, and it's good.
There's a foul against Mincy.
Easy call. It was reach around from behind.
It's kind of an interesting lineup by Coach King. They don't have a lot of pure scoring on the floor right now.
Hernandez took it all the way, kissed it off the back, and dropped it in. Richmond in a little bit of trouble, throws it out, and he ends up back in Knight's hands. That's Banks bringing it back all by himself. Off of a very careless Hollier's hands, and it's going to be Flight ball.
Watson out and Garvin Gordon back in. Ooh, they say the flight went off, or the ball went off the flight player. I'm not so sure about that.
I'm not so sure about that either. Daniels pretty much dove in, extended his whole self into that one, and was able to get a hand on it. Yeah. Somehow it's back in their hands.
Palm Beach players don't have a whole lot of respect for the players on the flight floor right now, on the floor for the flight, rather. So they're overplaying on defense.
Daniel's able to get one in.
Watch what I'm saying. It's they're turning up the pressure. Oh, Cintron was hammered. No call.
Hernandez gets it out to Daniels.
Oh, they blew the layup. They still have the ball.
Flight turning it up a little bit on defense. That was a lob.
Rebound, Rodriguez.
Good rebound by Rodriguez. Was pretty much down there all by himself, so was able to pick it up pretty easy. Rodriguez looking around, thinking, finds Gordon.
Gordon baseline jumper.
Sends it right across the top of the rim. Knights with a good behind-the-back pass to center it back up, set it back down with Banks.
Flay bringing in some reinforcements. Watson, Adamson, and Russell to get some more offense on the floor.
Richmond's bringing it. Gets it in, dumps it out.
Oh, up and around, oh good. That's a great hustle by Cintron.
Cintron turned it up, you could tell. Something clicked in his internal system. He flipped a switch, and he's been taking some risky moves in close combat trying to get the ball back. Results to him going to the line. He's got a little bit of a limp going on right now. Just under a minute to go. Flight lead by one.
Be some substitutions here after the first free throw.
Cintron comes up with one.
Just under a minute to play here in the third quarter, 73-71.
We're taking a few guys in. We got a lot of tall people in for the flight. Centro comes up with another one. Winds the deficit back out to three.
That was a bad shot by Lewis. Even if he had made it, I would still say it was a bad shot. And another foul on Palm Beach. So we'll go back down to the other end, shoot some more free throws. This time it's going to be Garvin Gordon, I believe.
Lewis is trying to shoot through double or triple coverage. Wasn't any way that was going to fly.
It looks like Cintro needs to come out.
This is Gordon.
If he makes this free throw, then they'll be able to bring the substitutions in.
In and out the bowl. Right. Misses his first. Adamson coming in.
And Nenwick,
bringing some much-needed help on defense.
Nenwick comes in for Palm Beach as well, number 21.
Gets the second one, winds the deficit out to four, and we have Lewis bringing it back, taking it all by himself. Try to get a little bit of a jump fake out to Hernandez, who takes a three and makes it.
Hernandez is talking a little smack to Adamson, and Adamson gave him a little elbow on the way down the floor.
Brought the deficit back down to one, and there's a foul on the floor. The foul called on Knights, number 33, Lewis. Hernandez and the ref had a little bit of a verbal altercation.
That's four fouls on Lewis.
Hernandez with his hands up, still trying to figure out where this is coming from, and going back to talk to the ref, sending the ref down towards coach. Meanwhile, there's an easy layup right there. Russell made his first. We're going to see if he can get his second one. And he does. Winds it back out
somebody
to three.
Stop the ball. There we go.
Lewis trying to work the angles, dancing around, gets it out to Banks. Banks standing at the top, just 20 seconds left to go. Banks trying to drive in, gets a jumper in,
tremendous
kisses
defense.
It off the back, and it's in Watson's hands now. Watson sends it up to Adamson, lost control. Richmond picks it up. Good move by Richmond, able to kiss it off the backboard for two more, and that's a five-point lead with 5 seconds to go.
Three, two, one. Lewis scores.
Lewis gets one in.
At the buzzer.
With just about 1 second or so left. And we're going into the fourth quarter. Should be 77-79, I believe.
Yeah, I was wondering about that myself.
One says 75 and the other says 76.
I think part of the bulb was burnt out on one side. You know, I think a lot of the Flight's transition defense problems is that they just don't pick up the ball early enough. They let the person that's bringing the ball up dribble all the way into, you know, at least into the three-point line before even anybody even begins to challenge him. And once you let that guy get ahead of steam, he's difficult to stop. They need to pick him up at half court or even before half court.
Exactly.
I think that would slow down his fast breaks quite a bit.
Exactly. If they tried to get some guys to get in between, try to slow him down, once they get the momentum, that's when they're hard to stop. Once they get find their speed and find their stride and can take it all the way, it's harder to stop and you risk more fouls that way. Fourth quarter starts now. It's Flight ball into Richmond. Richmond taking it to half court, and he's met by Hernandez.
We're going to go under the premise that it's 79-76 Flight until they change the scoreboard.
Adamson to Gordon, out to Richmond again, who was on the arc looking for a shot, but no good. Gets it back into Adamson, double team, back out to Richmond. Looked for his three, blocked by Hernandez. Gives probably Hernandez a little bit of an ego boost, who runs it back in and puts it in for an easy two.
And just like
Hernandez
that,
goes back out
again
to Richmond. Richmond taking it in, dumps
good
it into Gordon.
Gordon
gets his hands on the rim and the ball in the hoop. I count that as a dunk in my book. And draws a foul.
Gordon took it strong to the cup, and that's what happens when you go up strong.
The foul on Knights number 21. That's Network.
And
Gordon picks up his and one.
Big three-point play there. 82-78, four-point Flight lead. That's way off. No, it's not. It's good.
Banks found Daniels, who took a really easy three-point shot. Gets that deficit back to within one.
That looked wide right from my vantage point.
Adamson took a deep two-point shot. Didn't come up with it. Hernandez finds the ball in transition, gets it back out to Daniels. Daniels finds Banks. Banks takes a three-point shot, bounces it off the rims and miss. And it's back to Lewis.
Lewis in the game with five fouls. And what just happened? Lewis stopped because he thought they were going to call a blocking foul, and they didn't call one. Lewis just stopped playing. That was one of the most peculiar things I've seen in a long time.
some controversy with the coaches and the head table. And the Knights are bringing in number 17. That's Heath, another tall guy to help on the defensive end. With Watson and Gordon on the floor, they're going to need it. Flight ball inbounded to Richmond. Moving up as Russell moves back up into the paint. Richmond back to Russell. Russell gets it to Watson, who makes a power move in, lays it up.
Ooh.
Almost gets his own rebound and tips it back.
The ball's loose on the floor.
Watson comes up with it on the floor. Watson with a nice move and picks up a nice bucket.
I can see why he had 40 points the other night.
Hernandez with another three, in and out, and Adamson gets the rebound, hands it back off to Richmond, gets it to Russell underneath the hoop, lays it in for two.
Good look.
Knights kissed it off of the ceiling tiles, which sends it back, trying to go for a fast break situation, and threw it a little bit too high, kissed it off the tile.
Palm Beach panicking just a little bit, and there's so much time left, it's really inexcusable and unexplainable. But we'll take it.
Adamson with the flight inbound. Looking around.
There's a steal.
Tried to one-hand dump it to I don't know who it was.
He was going to pass it into Watson, but somebody stepped in the passing lane, but it already sort of left his hand. He couldn't do anything about it by then.
Adamson taking it on his own. Has a little bit of trouble with handles. Gets it to Russell, who hands it off to Watson. Watson comes up with another bucket.
Good unselfish interior passing by the flight that time.
Adamson trying to sneak up. Make a defensive stop. Banks and Russell. Banks takes it in, kisses it off the glass for another 2 points.
88-85, 9:15 to go.
Offense has really stepped up. Last quarter, we saw kind of a slower
offense. Timeout.
And jump ball. Richmond was hooked up inside of Heath. Was trying to show the referee that he was hooked inside, but still going for a jump ball.
I would say a minor height advantage here for the Palm Beach Knights. And I say that sarcastically.
Richmond and Heath in the middle. Heath with a really easy tip-off win. Lewis to Hernandez to Banks on the outside. Banks decides to go for the three, and it comes
Watson
up short.
Just dared him to shoot it.
Hernandez with a three. And Gordon with a nice rebound finds Adamson all the way at the end. Adamson missed it. Watson brings up the rear after the double coverage and is able to get it in. And it looks like Lewis is struggling a little bit coming off of the wall. Lewis is back, picks it up outside to Banks on the three-point line, and another miss.
Oh, another flop.
Some of the best acting we've seen so far.
Banks is tremendous at flopping.
Flight with a five-point advantage.
I understand it that Chris Watson is strong, but come on. Good defense by Russell that time, but they didn't. Yep. Adamson does a tremendous job taking the charge.
Absolutely. Very commendable. Sometimes you got to take one for the team, and that was a situation where that needed to happen.
He finally got a call to go his way.
You said earlier that you thought the Knights were getting a little more desperate. I would agree they seem to be taking a lot more risky three-point shots, just trying to close the gap. The flight keeping it very solid at 5 points hasn't really gotten much higher than that. but it's going to be flight ball Gordon to bring it in. And Jones ready to receive. Jones moving in, dodges double coverage. Adamson back to Gordon, who drives in, kisses it off, rolls all the way around and misses it. And Adamson tried to come up with it and ends up hitting the floor. And the foul is on number three. That's Quinn.
Adamson has spent more time on the floor than...
He looks a little dazed and confused to me.
What's a good analogy? Spent more time on the floor than the mop. How about that? He's been on the floor a lot.
He doesn't need to get hit in the head anymore today.
No.
Just over 8 minutes to go. The lead is 90-85 for the flight. Guess they thought they were going for a free throw situation.
They're going to let Heath come in the game.
Guess he fouled out. Flight to inbound. Jones deep into the corner to Richmond, who instead of taking the shot, tries to drive in and ends up losing it. In all the traffic.
He should have flopped.
Works for the other team.
It's a good shot by Lewis on the other end. Cuts the lead to three.
Watson with a deep pass. Back to Gordon. Gordon takes it with ease but misses it. Doesn't quite come up with it.
He's missed a couple of layups now that I'm sure he would love to have back. Rebound Watson.
Good move by Watson trying to navigate through the lane here. Finds the rim easy, shows Gordon how to do a layup. Said, watch this. Here's how you put it in. This is Hernandez bringing it back for the Knights.
Once again, the lead up to 5:07:18 to go. Near steal by Richmond
with a really risky defensive move. Ends up getting it from behind, but it's still Knights ball. Really good hustle. Showed some good instincts there on defense, trying to go for the swipe when he could have risk losing position.
That's it.
And then followed it up.
A good quick way to endear yourself to your new teammates by hustling like that.
Hernandez gets it in. Finds Lewis at the top of the arc. Lewis making a move.
Good
fakes,
fake.
Jumps.
Good rebound.
Williams comes up with it.
To Watson.
Gave Watson a little bit of lead room. Watson
and
still.
They call a block.
That's an offensive foul. Watson shows a lot of...
They called the block against Banks.
Watson really thought he should have come up with that. I'm sure he'll be kicking himself for that later. But he can make up for it with some of these free throws. And the towel comes back out. We have a fan walking across the floor.
I do have to say that... If I was the referee, I probably would have called a charge against Watson that time. I'll have to look at it again on tape someday, but in real time, I would have called that a charge.
Here comes Watson with his first free throw attempt. Taking his time, puts it up, and it's in easy.
Under 7 to go, 6-point lead. For the flight.
6-point lead could be 7. Widest lead I think we would have here in the fourth quarter. 7-point lead.
Watson
Knights
thought he
ball.
Missed that one. He was jumping into the lane.
Knights are getting a little more desperate, a little more risky with some of their plays. Daniels gets it to Banks, playing around with it and lose it.
Here comes something
Watson
good.
On the open
here
floor.
Here comes something good. Oh, he just laid it in. I thought he was
Watson
going to
throw taking it easy. He was really good to recognize somebody was coming up on his rear, so he took the safe route of just laying it in.
Near steal by St. Remy.
Still going to be Knights ball. Underneath the rim in their own territory.
Flight have now opened up a 9-point lead with 6.5 to go.
It's a good place to be here in the fifth. Fourth, I mean. Hernandez airballs a three.
Oh, they're letting him play now. They were calling everything before. Now they're just letting him clobber each
Williams
other.
With a deep pass to St. Remy. Bounces off Hernandez. Nice. His hand still comes up with it, and another 2 points.
Good body control by St. Remy. Able to grab the ball, turn, and lay it in. Very graceful play. And there we've got a foul. That foul is going to go against St. Remy. Double-digit Flight lead now at 98-87, though Lewis can cut into it just a little bit here. 6:04 to go. Richmond just said to Coach King they're frustrated. Two successful free throws by Lewis. That makes it...
Knights finally found the rhythm on free throws, I guess. Jones has it about half court inside to Williams. Williams making a move, and it's back out to St. Remy, who gets it around the rim to Jones.
That would have been a big
one. Takes a three and misses it.
Stop the ball. That's not a bad foul by... Watson.
Watson picks up another. He's at about 3 or 4 now.
Got a timeout. Flight retained their 9-point lead, 98-89, 5:43 to go.
Spoke too soon, I guess, on finding the rhythm on those free throws.
Has been kind of a back-and-forth affair, and you kind of wonder if the Knights maybe have one more run in them yet with 5:43 to go to try to make this a close game. I don't remember the game ever being more than an 11-point lead for either side during this entire game.
I think you're right. It's gone back and forth pretty closely, as you said. And I would say historically in this game, the Knights have usually done a pretty good job of trying to close the gap right at the end of the quarter. So there could be another potential good run from the Knights that they still have in them to try to seal the deal. Yeah. But you also have to take into account that they've lost some of their players to fouls, and so... We'll see what happens. Here comes another free throw from Lewis.
One more. And he's got it. 98-90. It's an 8-point lead.
We've seen how quickly they can shorten the deficit.
No. That's the wrong line. He called an over and back, and it was the wrong line. He was looking at the wrong line. He was looking at the wrong line, Mark.
A faulty call.
He was looking at the...
Faulty call gets the ball back into the Knights' hands.
There's some more lines down here for volleyball or something.
Yeah, there's a couple extra.
EJ takes the charge from Lewis. There's another foul on Lewis. That's 5 on Lewis.
Lewis is coming out of the game. One of the key players for the Knights so far has put up a lot of points.
That's 5.
I don't think he realizes that he's fouled out.
That's 5 on him.
five fouls on him. It's five fouls on him.
That's what he just said. That's what Matt just said, yeah.
He realizes that there's... Oh, maybe not. He's posted up like he's still got a couple left. He's still in the game, even though that's his fifth foul.
That should be a technical foul if you play with five fouls.
Williams dumps it to Watson, rethinks his shot travel. At the last minute. Yep. Travel, that's one of the first travel calls of the game.
5:16 to go.
So no word on Lewis, who's supposedly playing with five fouls.
Oh, Graham loses the handle.
KO situation, Richmond comes up and underneath,
no
falls
good.
Down.
Watson follows it up.
Watson brings up the rear and cleans it up. Gets it back to a 10-point, 100-90.
There's a foul against Williams. And the Flight have reached the century mark. It's 110-90, 4:53 to go. I don't think it's in the Flight's best interest to get into a track meet with Palm Beach at this point. I think
even though they are stronger, these guys are probably a lot quicker.
I think they need to just slow it up and run their offense. That's what's gotten them this far.
Absolutely, I agree.
Samuda misses. Rebound, Watson. They called a foul against Richmond off the ball.
In disbelief, threw his hands up, doesn't quite believe. Guess they thought he was grabbing onto the jersey.
That was completely away from the action, too, so I really don't know what was going on there.
Either way.
It's kind of an elbowing call, I guess, is basically what the referee is explaining to him. Richmond nearly gets a steal. Three-point attempt for Banks. No good.
Banks airballs a three. That's been the story of their life. Richmond out on the open floor.
And he lays it in.
Kisses it in. 102-90.
There's a steal. Great hands by Ernest Jones.
Richmond takes the risky three.
Might have been a better idea just to run some clock there. Set up the offense. Boy, Banks was going nowhere productive fast, but he got bailed out by a call there. Who's the foul on?
I will believe it was on number 22, Williams.
But it's a 12-point Flight lead down to 4:14 to go.
We'll see if the Knights try to rally back and try to extend the game out, get some fouls in there, wear everybody out. But I imagine they don't have very more fouls left that they can get.
102-91 is the score. 102-92.
Looks like Banks gets both of his free throws that he attempts.
Lead is back to 10.
Looks like Williams will be giving the inbound. St. Remy is close by. Jones a little further ahead. Cleaning up the floor a little bit.
They have Watson and four fairly good ball handlers on the floor. This is good strategy by Coach King right now. Because you got to know they're going to come at him with some pressure.
Williams at St. Remy exchange for a little bit. Gets it to Watson. Drives in. Gets right by the defense. Kisses it in for a really easy basket. Deficit is 12 points.
Nobody wants to step in front of Watson and take a charge.
Watson rebounds with ease. Gets it up to Williams. Good Williams pass. To Richmond. Richmond kisses it off the glass and draws the foul. We're going for a three-point play.
Richmond landed hard on his hip, but he looks to be okay.
There's another player, supposedly with five fouls. Number 30. That would be Graham.
Graham.
They're bringing him out, but I still notice that Lewis is still in. Must not have had five like we thought.
Well, the scores table was saying 5.
Hernandez also looking to make a move coming in for the Knights.
Yeah, he's their 3-point sharpshooter. I'm kind of surprised they didn't bring him in before now. It's 106-92.
Here comes Richmond on the line going to complete his 3-point play, pick up the and one. It's up. Off the back, no good. No 3-point play for Richmond. It's going to come back the Flight's way.
Good pressure defense by St. Remy causes the turnover.
Daniels is a little careless with the ball, ends up losing it, giving it back to the Flight. Back on their side, St. Remy's going to be bringing it in. Jones is nearby, dumps it to Jones. Watson looks like he's up to something. Richmond outside the arc, dumps it to Watson, who makes the power play.
If I remember correctly, it was either a 1 or 2 point Flight lead to start the fourth quarter. And right now it's a 14-point lead with Watson at the line threatening to make it a bigger lead than that.
Foul on Banks.
So the Flight have just sort of seized control of the game here in the fourth quarter.
Here comes Watson looking to get up some money in and out, and he's a little frustrated with that. 24 is coming out for 15. That's Hollier coming back. Watson going to try again. I believe this is the biggest lead of the game for either side. Knights have kind of fallen apart, losing so much to the fouls that happened earlier.
Not a bad foul by Jones, because as soon as Banks turned around, he would have realized there was 3 of his teammates down court and only 1 Flight player. Every point that the Knights can possibly get right now is critical, so Banks needs to make both of these to help his team get back in the game.
Banks' free throw is up. Off the back, no good.
Still 3:22 to go. A lot can happen in that period of time, so the Flight shouldn't be feeling too good about themselves. Meanwhile, nobody's back against Richmond.
Banks misses free throw. Hernandez tries to throw up another 3.
There's Richmond.
There's St. Remy to Richmond. Kisses it off for another easy 2-point bucket. 109-92.
Delay of game.
And some kind of warning for
delay
the White.
Game, because Richmond caught the ball after he laid it in. So they called delay a game warning. Good pass to Hoylett from Banks. But could it be too little too late? 109-94.
St. Remy's got it, gets it up to Watson. Jones is coming up to meet him at the basket. Watson wasn't quite able to come up with it with all the defense standing there.
Yeah, there's a foul.
Watson cuts in and tries to get it, ends up getting a foul.
Watson, you can tell Watson wants a vicious throwdown before this game's over with.
Watson's not going to let this end without going down swinging. He's going to fight for every point that he feels like they should get.
No, actually, this... no, he's asking out of the game.
Here comes Gordon to replace him.
Maybe that's why he took that ball in himself. He knew that was going to be his last hurrah for the day.
Lewis gets one. Here comes Gordon to replace Watson. Really wide lead, 14 points.
St. Remy needs some help.
Deep pass gets it back to the Knights.
Nobody came to help St. Remy, and he just had to get rid of the ball. Of course, he could have called timeout. Maybe,
Hernandez finally gets the 3 he's been looking for this whole quarter.
Don't look now, but it's a 10-point game.
Hernandez takes that pass off easy. And they're setting up Hernandez for another three-point shot. Richmond goes running by, but he airballs a three.
Boy, Flight caught a break there if he made that.
That could have been bad news. Could have been the beginning of the end.
Richmond fouled.
Hernandez picks up another foul.
That's got to be...
It's close.
He's got a bunch of fouls against him, too.
Looks like...
You would never know this was Richmond's first game with the Flight ever.
You really wouldn't. He's blended in so well and been able to really work himself into their offensive patterns and plays, be able to come up with some stuff and finds his way to be at the right place at the right time. Misses his first free throw, but he's going to go for his second. Misses his second one. Relaxing on his free throws. Deficit is still 10 points. Goes right over the top of Gordon.
Don't throw it away. Slow it up. There you go. Good job, Garvin. Hernandez does a nice job.
Utilizes the playground rules. Bounced it off Adamson's back and then blames it on him.
Flight lead still 10. We're under 2 minutes to go now, minute 55. But there's still a lot of things can happen. 5 I might reinsert Watson into the game just to feel a little bit more secure about my lead.
Just under 2 minutes to go. The Flight's lead is 10, 109-99.
Trying to improve their record to 2-3 on the season.
Hernandez gets it into Banks just barely. Jones was there, met him defensively. Jones really being aggressive makes Banks trip up and lose control. Gordon rises but misses and it gets it back out.
Oh.
Daniels went for it, wasn't able to come up with it.
Fouls on Corey Williams, though, and Daniels goes to the line to try to cut it to 8. Minute 39 to go now. Big miss.
Very big miss. You know that they need all the points they can get right now with just about 99 seconds left.
All those free throws they missed early in the game have come back to hunt them.
Adamson's going to inbound, gets it to Richmond. Adamson moves back up. Meanwhile, Richmond passes it.
Look out. Bad pass by Jones.
Jones was there, rose to the occasion, and met a taller Lewis and was able to block the dunk. Seconds left. Big block by Jones, but it's still a couple free throws for Lewis on the line. Lewis is up with his first, down and good. Adamson's coming out, in comes Russell to replace him.
And just like that, it's a 7-point contest.
crazy things have happened.
Jones back to Russell. 10 on the shot clock. Good pass to Sewell. Excellent head fake. Up and under, he lays it in.
That got to a 9-point lead. Just over a minute to go.
They're adding 3 seconds to the clock. 109.
Are they saying 109 for the time or the score?
The time.
109 on the time. Hernandez has got it. Into Lewis it goes. Lewis shows good handles coming down the stretch.
Daniels lost control of the ball, and then as he went to get it, he stepped on the out-of-bounds line.
And it's flight ball.
Big turnover.
Lewis gets it into Richmond. Richmond taking it down the stretch.
Oh, terrible.
Bad pass.
Daniels and missed the dunk.
Daniels misses a dunk in embarrassing fashion, to say the least.
Wow.
That's a foul on
Daniels,
Russell.
Daniels shaking his head going, how did I do that? 47 seconds left.
A couple more for Lewis. Lewis is on the line taking his time. His first free throw is up, and it's good.
It's an 8-point game. St. Remy in for Richmond. Not sure why Watson's not in there right now.
Lewis is gearing up for a second free throw, taking his time. Here it goes, it's up, and it's good.
And the lead back down to 7, 111 to 104.
St. Remy's got it. It's a quick dump off. Now Gordon making moves into the paint. Misses it.
Williams
with a good
with
follow.
Gordon wanted a foul. There's
points.
A steal by St. Remy. Oh, no. I guess he touched the end line there.
St. Remy went for a good save after a nice deflected pass, but ends up getting it back to the Knights. Slows the momentum down just a little bit. Hernandez dumps it to Lewis
lead.
And gets it back. Now Lewis with it, takes it into the paint, and chokes on a dunk.
That's their third missed dunk in about the last 2.5 minutes. Daniels has missed 2 lefty dunks, although one of them was a foul by Ernest Jones. And Daniels missed the uncontested righty dunk a mere seconds ago. And that's a big reason why the Flight still cling to a 9-point lead here.
9-point lead with 27 seconds to go. It's a comfortable place to be going into the final second. St. Remy on the line. His first free throw is up and good. Widening the gap just a little bit further. 10-point.
Is it too soon to call it? Can we call it now? I think we can call it now.
I think so. I think you're right. Crazy things have happened.
Good rebound by Gordon.
No basket for Gordon, even though he made it. Foul on number 30 of the Knights. That's Graham. And here comes Gordon to the line. Knights just keep giving them opportunities to make more and more free throws.
We can definitely call it now.
And I believe Graham just fouled out. So in comes Banks once again. Gordon on the line taking his time. First free throw is up and good. That's 11 points now. 25 seconds to go. They'd have to work really hard to come back from a deficit like this.
And another stolen rebound.
Wow. Kickball violation.
If I'm the Palm Beach coach, I'm teaching my players how to box out on free throws. That just cannot happen. This is Jones. Jones is going to dribble out the clock if they'll let him.
Jones working on it. He's going to try to dribble it out. Passes it out to St. Remy, who's going to hold on to it. takes it inside, gonna get a free bucket, why not? Misses it. Here comes the Knights. Back down. Russell comes up with the steal, and that is the game.
That'll do it.
Your Florida Flight win 115-104 here against the Palm Beach Knights.
Stay tuned for some post-game player and coach interviews. Flight break up in a very close game. It was a 1 or 2 point lead. I don't remember which going into the fourth. In the fourth, it never looked back, although they did make it interesting. Palm Beach was within 7 and a couple of missed dunks away from making it even closer than that. So the Flight have to feel good about this win as they improve to 2-3 on the season. And let's see if we can get Coach King up here.
Let's see if we can. King after very impressive 115-104 win against Palm Coach. Coach, how do you feel?
I feel relieved. I thought we played okay, but we made it. We got it. We'll take it the way we can get it. But that was a hard win.
It was a hard win. You guys were working hard. Coming in close to the end of the first half, it was going back and forth a lot. You guys were really close to the end of the half. What was your strategy going into halftime, coming into the second half, to help widen the deficit and help make?
Well, one of the things we wanted to run more offensive sets against them and actually set up a little bit of a press, more full court press, not really a trap press, but I wanted us to run them off some screens, tire them out a little bit, and overplay their passing lane because I felt like they were tired than us. I felt like we were in better shape than them, but we really needed a little bit more cohesiveness. We went 12 deep today, so you know, the guys bought into that, which I'm proud of, but when you do that, it's very easy to kind of lose chemistry in the middle of a game. So.
And then in the fourth quarter, it seemed like a switch turn, and your guys really took off. What do you attribute to that? What do you think made them work harder and finish the game really strong, whereas the Knights kind of struggled coming down the stretch and struggling offensively?
I think just being receptive to the coaching. One of the things I told them is we have to get back, sprint to half court, turn, and get back. I mean, we're staying up in the backcourt a lot when they get the ball. But really, the other part is just hunger. We're 1-3, now we're 2-3 now. We needed this win, and Palm Beach is a very good team, and they can shoot the lights out at any time, so we try to chase them off the three line, make sure they can only match us basket for basket, because I felt like we couldn't, we didn't have a problem scoring, we just had a problem making sure that they didn't jump out to a 6-0 run with 2 3-pointers.
Absolutely, and you definitely worked smarter and not harder here in the fourth quarter, and made your guys come out with a good win. Coach King here at the Florida Flight, I'm Hank Taylor.
Thanks, Hank.
Not a problem. You need anything else for me?
No.
You scored 7 of the first 9 points. You feeling good at the beginning of the game?
Yeah, I was feeling pretty healthy. After coming off that little groin injury I had maybe about 2 weeks ago, just been rehabbing, and all I knew was just push shots up.
So what did you guys do in the fourth quarter to break open the close game?
I believe we just played a little bit more team basketball and got a lot more aggressive than normal.
Yeah.
Yeah.
You turned up the screws defensively a lot, too.
Yeah, we definitely had to.
Yeah.
Had to.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, they're a lot better than they were last year, for sure. They're a good team.
Yeah, they came out of the box a lot from last year, even past couple seasons. They came out of the box a lot.
So you were close to halftime. What did Coach King say to you at halftime?
Basically, you know, we've been through this adversity before, and it's up to us that we got to get over the hump. You know, every time we come out, it's always on us, really, pretty much, that we put ourselves behind. But now we seize the opportunity, especially from playing in the first game and seeing a lot from how we did well and what we didn't do well first game. So, you know, put it onto this game and we came out.
Yeah. So from a personal standpoint, you played for Heartland last year. You won a championship with them, and now you're back with the Flight. How does it feel to be back with the Flight?
Honestly, it feels great.
Yeah.
Especially the bond I had with these guys for those past 2 years I was here. It was like no other. You know, I missed it. You know, things went sour the past season. And, you know, don't get me wrong, Heartland, still my brothers as well. But, you know, I'm over here with the Flight, and, you know, we're taking off. Florida Flight, baby.
Right. Thanks, Greg.
Appreciate it.
Congratulations.
Yes, sir.
That's all right. Who's next? Come on.
And so now we're here with Corey Williams, a couple of really big buckets down the stretch.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, yeah.
So tell me about the couple of the I know you had a follow. What do you think?
We got to fight harder than that, but that's why I play the game.
What do you mean by that? We got to fight harder than that?
I mean, we started to play a little sloppy towards the end. I think we were stuck at 109 for a while they was coming back. So anything to go ahead and energize the team, little plays is what matter. Follows, tip backs, everything like that, it's just all part of the game.
Yeah. Now, I just asked Greg this question. It was a two-point game, I believe, going into the fourth quarter. And the next thing I knew, the Flight were up by like 10 or 11. What happened? What'd you do to
energy. I mean, that's what guys got to come into the game with, energy. We tell the bench players everything. Mm-hmm. Come into the game with energy, give it your all. For 2 minutes, you should be dead tired. Mm-hmm. So the bench really stepped up tonight, I can say that.
Yeah, they did.
And our defense actually stepped up too. Mm-hmm. Helps out. I don't know how many charges we had, but, you know, that was a good thing because it took the momentum away from them.
And you did an excellent job of taking care of the basketball in the fourth quarter too, I think. That was a big deal.
Have to. I mean,
not just you, but the team.
Everybody. Yeah, everybody. Mm-hmm. And I think that's something that we learned from the past couple of years with leads like this. We have to take care of the ball and control the tempo of the game. Yeah. So I think that's one of the biggest things.
So how does it feel to have a big monster on the back line like Chris Spector?
It feels good. It feels good. It feels so much better knowing that someone's going to be there for your help side. We just got to get him to block some more shots. Yeah. He's taking too many charges. Yeah. But I know he's going to get into the flow of things, and soon you'll see him sending up balls into like the third bleach over there somewhere.
Yeah, and Mr. Richmond played a good game for his first game with you guys too.
He did. He did. Alex, he really came in and he gave some big minutes. He gave some big hustle plays, especially towards the end of the game. Mm-hmm. Nice assist. He gave me a nice one down there.
Yeah, he did.
I was shocked. But, you know, he's a great player. I already see that.
All right. Congratulations, Corey. Good win, man.
Thank you.
All right. See you next week.
Definitely.
All right.